Shadowlands. This time we're here rescuing Thrall from the Maw, from Dorghast, the Tower of the Damned, to be precise here. I'm going on my Fury Warrior this time. I've been enjoying Fury. I've dabbled with arms a little bit. Now and then, but I like the rotation of Fury. I always find myself coming back to play it, and apparently in the next class tweaks on, I think, January 12th, I believe it's coming out. Buff to damage, so that'll definitely make it a little bit more competitive. I just thought I'd make this since I'm doing I've been doing all the other ones. We rescued Bane, and we rescued Jaina. I figured we'd rescue Thrall and Anduin as well. I am chewing some gum as well, which hopefully isn't annoying some people. It has hurt in the past. I started doing this, but I'm trying not to be annoying with it either way. But so Fury should be, it probably won't be amazing still, but hopefully it'll be a little bit more competitive. I just think it's much more engaging than arms. Okay, that's pretty useful. We already got a pretty common but slightly good condemn one. Makes condemn a little bit stronger. Is what it's all about when you are a Venthyr warrior, and that's the way to go. Just looks awesome. Do that overhead two-handed smash. But post Dorghast nerf, it's been pretty easy. On the 8th floor sometimes, depending on what I get in terms of anima power, it can be kind of a pain, but these special little quest ones that you do to rescue people are always easier than your average Dorghast run, so we shouldn't blow right through here. And really, another reason for doing this is I was saving it for a video, but I also just want to do a, was it Twisted Towers? I think something like that. I don't know. Came out. It's the next wing of Dorghast. That has a bunch of floors and layers. And I'm going to do that later. Give that a shot, see what that's all about with some friends. So, and you need to do this. You need to rescue Thrall before unlocking the ones about that involve killing mall rats or breaking the jars. Ran through the fire there, but that was fine. Somehow he held it all back. It was probably the when you attack a new creature thing. That's actually really strong. And I didn't mean to use recklessness, but that's okay. Up a lot more frequently, which is really awesome. Yeah, this shouldn't take long at all. We're already on floor two, and we're just blowing through things here. Schedules. My wife got a new job, and this past year and a half, I've been just waking up early and just doing these videos in the morning. That's where it's quiet, or at least interruptive. You know, I don't have to have my wife stay out of this room and try not to make as much noise while making these videos. So, but she's been getting up earlier for a new job, so there hasn't been as much of time. So, you know, I'll rework things, I'll make it work again. But I have a lot of videos in backlog recorded that need a little editing, a little voice over narration work there. A lot of Cooking with Khan videos on backlog, and still as always a lot of ideas for videos if, you know, I just need the time to sit down and make them. But the gameplay ones are easiest, and you know, I enjoy them. Up on what I've been experimenting with in WoW, or with class updates and things. fun just to do that. Let's see what we got here. Anything good? That one's good for healing. I don't know if we'll actually need it on this run, but we're getting a lot of survivability and kind of like utility items or anima powers. Guy over here, heavily bound soul remnant. They have taken everything. All right, let's see what's going on here. Okay. Well, I didn't do that right, but I got through it, and that's all that matters there. Cutscene here. Oh, I just said all that matters. That's weird. All that matters is we now possess the necessary instrument. We must begin its preparation. Leave him to me. You've seen what he is capable of. When he believes in the cause, a measure of patience may yield superior results. Very well. We have our weapon. Now we shall hone it. Okay. So, okay, this is floor 3, so this is intermission level, really. Interesting that we got a little cutscene there. We hadn't gotten that with Bane or Jaina, but things are ramping up, I guess, in the campaign. I almost said crusade. That's not quite right. Are any of these good? I guess I'll just... Oh, we're 2 off from buying a second one. I might just save it. None of these are especially exciting. Maybe we'll get something here. Okay. I'll buff Condemn. There's one that's really good that you can get where if you cast Condemn 30 times, you can just use it whenever you want instead of only above 80 or below 35. Ouch. As I was walking over that, I realized it was a trap. Let's see how much we heal for. Boom, right back to full health. It's not gonna help on a boss fight, but it's definitely gonna be nice until then. Ouch. These traps do so much damage. Way too much on higher levels. Yeah, my least favorite things are these. You gotta juke them out. Just, you know, forget about it and hit some. Instantly regret it. Power for us. I'll take that crit damage. just done with it. I'm trying to run through real quick. But you gotta stay on your toes all the way through Dorgast. Those big blasts there will mess you up too. Pretty much every trap will. This guy. The one thing is, Fury does not have really any cooldowns like that you would save up for bosses, really. Recklessness is on a low cooldown, so your rotation for pulls is essentially going to be your same rotation for boss fights. Wish it had like maybe one. There's the one I was telling you guys about 30 times, and then you can use it whenever. We've been killing things so quickly that it's barely even been an issue, but it'll be nice nonetheless. Say here. They have taken everything. I should read some more creepypastas at some point. If you guys know of any that I should check out that I haven't done before, let me know. I usually save that for Halloween just because it's fun as a tradition, but I like doing those. Anyway. In here. Didn't even directly attack that one. I think we can probably pull all these, right? We're powerful enough. As Fury Warrior, you just, if you get the right things that buff condemn damage, you just kind of one-shot everything. But a little bit harder on the upper levels. Of it. Jumps in the air and slams down with two swords. Boom. Boom. has been way faster than a lot of the floors on higher levels that I've been on. I've heard this next part, the twisted whatever. I don't know why, I've just forgot the name right now while making this video, but I heard that takes a long time as well, even on each individual floor. That guy say, are you real? Please take my blessing. Empowered Imperial Consular. Let's see if we can reduce the cooldown by the end of this fight too on our recklessness. Seconds off the cooldown or something. Oh, she pacified me. Let's see. Oh, it was at 40 seconds. We took 50 seconds off there, right? Or more than that. What did I say? We took like 50 seconds, yeah. That's pretty good. I don't think we even need that. Let's just grab that extra anima. And here we are at the last floor. That went a lot faster than I was expecting it to, honestly. I feel like the Jaina and Bane ones were like full, long floors to go through. This was really quick. Those were like the tiniest floors possible. Mawwalker, have you lost your way? A darkness looming. An intrusion into my domain. Beyond God, he senses us. And he has Arctyrant Xerios. Oh yeah. I'm excited. Been dabbling with more jerkies. And right now, I have a pork jerky, which I haven't tried yet, dehydrating, and on it, it has a homemade duck sauce that I made. So, duck sauce is a condiment, if you are not familiar with that. It's usually what, like, Chinese food restaurants, in America at least, would give you. Dip like egg rolls and stuff in, but it goes well on pork. I've eaten it on pork before and I really like it. But yeah, if you're not familiar with what it is, it's mostly a base of a lot of apricot, like preserves, and then some different like spices and stuff to kick it up a notch and make it its own thing. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. I thought it would be an interesting combination. So, that'll be done in like a couple hours or so. But it smells good so far. That's always a good sign. And one plus of the dehydrator is delicious smelling stuff cooking all day. None of these are really that good. I'll go ahead and grab that one. A little bit of damage. The other ones are all healing and tanking. Except for that one. I think I can get both, yeah. I like getting the health just to have a ton. One time I had like 80,000 health. My friend was tanking it and I just had like more than double his health. I think I'll take that. That's actually, that'd be like 10% strength and agility and intellect. I'll be a very smart warrior in addition to a very strong warrior. Oh, look at Thrall up there. Doesn't look very happy. Lots of little guys down here as well. himself, but he's melting. No concern for a monster of tacos, which is my warrior's name, if you hadn't noticed that and thought that I was just crazy for a second. Interesting. The Waystone, our path out of here. I have seen only the darkest reaches of the Shadowlands. It is good to know there are places of hope as well. May the spirits of my ancestors be safe in realms of comfort and peace. Thrall's a chill dude. Someone who has played Alliance for most of the expansions. All our allies must be saved. You have braved torments beyond most mortals' understanding. Thanks to your efforts, Thrall, Jaina Proudmoore, and Bane Bloodhoof, how come Thrall doesn't get a last name, that's not fair, are safe. Yet so long as the jailer holds any hero of Azeroth, I fear he has power over us all. Oops. It seems Anduin has been taken deeper into the tower than the others. Before I risk peering inside, you must make one last attempt to find him. You say the jailer spoke of honing a weapon. I fear we are running out of time. Do not relent. Search the twisting corridors, that's what it's called, of Dorghast for any sign of the young lion. Okay, Twisting Corridors is open and we get 50 buckaroos. Very cool. We need to find a sign of the lion. Enter Dorghast and explore it. Okay. Very cool. So that'd be fun. The storyline of this has a lot of tie-ins to back to things from like Warcraft 3 and stuff, where some of the covenants you're talking to, you know, Uther and Kael'thas and Lady Vash and different people. I like that. I really enjoy anything that ties into the lore of Warcraft 3. That's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoy. video, and I'll see you guys next time.